So when you are done with the creation of table and later you got to know like you need to make some changes, if there is no data in the table, you can drop it and recreate it again. But in case your table is containing some data, and obviously you will not be able to delete or drop that particular table, what I can do, I can go for this alter table command, using which you can add, remove or modify any existing column in that particular table. So let's have a look in practical how this alter table works.
So now we saw how to create a table. As soon as we create a table, it is a data definition language. That means it is affecting the database structure. But if I will modify the structure of a table, that will also be counted as the data definition language, that is a DDL. So now let's see how can we modify the structure of a table once it is created. So this is the table students which we just created in the previous example. Now I'm gonna modify that itself. So what should I do is, I'll start with the alter. All the whatever thing you are going to change the structure, you will have to use the alter keyword for that. And again, the object type, that is a table, and the name, that is TBL students. Alright, so now this is the table name. What you want to change in that? If you want to add a particular column, you will have to write add the column name, let's say fees numeric 6 or 7, 2, that is for the decimal values. Alright, so let's execute that, and if I'll refresh here, you can see like here I got a new column called fees. But if you want to change the existing thing, like the existing column, rather than adding a new, you can also do that. How? Like alter table TBL students, let's say alter column, and here let's modify a column called fees itself, where I want to change the size of this one. So what can I do is alter column fees, make sure this column is existing, and here you can change the data type as well or the size. Alright, so what I can do is numeric 10, 2. So if I will execute this command itself, as I have selected this one, only this one will be executed. So you can see it's come successfully executed, and now let's refresh, and here you can see now it's 10, 2. Now if you want to drop a particular column, so for doing that, it's alter table TBL students, and now drop column, and here you can specify the column name. Let's say I want to remove the fees only. So as soon as I will execute that, again it got me a success message. It gave me a success message, and now here you can see like that column is removed. So using this alter command, you can actually add or modify or drop the column from a table. Now if you want to rename a particular column, so you can do that as well. But for that, here we are going to use some predefined stored procedure. As in SQL, we don't have an alter command for that. So let's see how can I rename a particular column now. So as you can see here, sp underscore rename is the name of stored procedure. Stored procedure is something like predefined functionality for your particular databases. And here to execute that stored procedure, we are using this execute or exec keyword. After that, I will have to specify what I want to rename. So TBL students, that is the table name, dot date of birth is the column which I want to rename. And I want to rename it to the DOB. You can also rename a table using this sp underscore rename stored procedure. But as here, I'm gonna rename a column, so here I have specified like I am going to rename a column so that it will not consider it a renaming of a table. So let's execute this one and refresh. You can see like here the column got renamed to DOB. So this is how you can modify the structure of a table once it is created.